Okay, Kemi, first of all, congratulations on another win. You must be well delighted with that performance.
Yeah, it could have been more, and the numbers game is there. But, you know, if you'd have said to me after six games in their group that we would be only 2 points behind England, you know, I would have said, there's no way that will happen. So that's the persistence that we have and how we want to get close to the upper echelons of women's football. Like England and Austria are right up there, and we're ahead of Austria in goal difference. We're in the second place at the moment, so goal difference was important tonight. We're 7 goals ahead of Austria, and obviously they've got a game in hand which would make them level with us, but we feel that we're putting up a great fight to try and challenge Austria especially, and we know if we can go there and get something out there, it would be fantastic.
First of all, congratulations on another great win tonight. Your thoughts on that one?
Yeah, thank you. Good performance from the girls. It's always going to be difficult. We expected that the opposition were going to come and sit in and make it difficult for us, especially what happened out there. So we knew that we were going to have to be at our best, and I thought the girls equipped themselves really, really well, and you know, they kept going to the end to get the goals that we needed. So, you know, we're making it as hard as we can for everybody else, and we can get up that get that goal difference up and keep putting the pressure on the other teams.
Right across the pitch today, but obviously a couple of key goal scorers, hat trick there for Kirsty McGuinness, 2 goals for Rachel Furness, and obviously a debut goal for Kerry Beattie. She must be delighted with those as well.
Yeah, definitely. Kerry scored her first goal for her country, and not only is it her first goal for her country, but she's a very passionate girl about playing for her country. She's so proud of that. And for her to get a goal, it must make her feel, I'm so happy for her. It's really, really good.
That win tonight takes us into second place, so it certainly puts the pressure on the Austria now to keep delivering.
Well, they play tomorrow night, so if they want to get above us, they've got to score a lot of goals tomorrow night to get that second place back, because we're going to be there. If we can stay there now to next April, to the next round of games, so that's important psychologically for us as well.
You've mentioned there, it's next April, we've got to wait to the next one. It's a nice run of form, Ron. It'd be nice to maybe have one a bit sooner, but give it a bit of time for preparation for that one as well.
Well, we have, and hopefully we'll go into our full-time programme in January, and then we have a trip hopefully into Spain in February, so we've got lots of work to do, lots of preparation to do. The girls will get a little bit of a break now for a while, a well-earned break I may add, but you know, we'll go back in January, and we'll be working hard, and we know the job in hand is going to be a tough one, so we've got to keep working.
You've now got a break of a few months before the next game. However, I know the players are hoping to go sort of full time at the start of the year. What sort of difference is that going to make for our next game?
Well, time will tell. You know, January, we're giving the girls, most of them, the senior girls, the rest of December off, prepare for Christmas, eat their turkey, and let's come in fresh in January and see where that takes us.
Okay. Just in final closing today, obviously is this the last time we'll see you all before Christmas? Do you want to give a final Christmas wish to the supporters just this evening?
Oh, listen, great shout, Colin. And, you know, I want to wish them a happy Christmas and happy New Year. I got that wrong, so it's Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. But hope that they have a really good time and get their throats watered down and get ready to support us in the new year. Thanks very much. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. That's goals from right across the pitch tonight. Obviously, Rachel Furness, a new record holder. Thoughts on her?
Delighted for her. Well deserved. Probably if she had her shooting boots on, she could maybe cut out a couple more. I know Simone probably was thinking she could have a couple as well, but it was really good to see Kerry Beattie getting her first international goal as well, which was delightful as well. So, goals all over the pitch. And the girls, the substitutions, everybody's played that's been in this camp. And we've brought players on, we've changed formations, and everybody's done their job. They know their roles, they know their responsibilities. They go out there and everybody gives 100%, and they don't fall short.
And finally, just before we go, this is our last game before Christmas. Can we get a wee Christmas greeting wish to the supporters from you?
Oh yeah, happy Christmas to everybody. I hope they have a very successful New Year as well as a peaceful Christmas, and hopefully they'll come back, and the Green White Army will be supporting us in the New Year as well.
That'll be fine. Kerry, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Appreciate that.